Good evening, Jim Graham with ABC News. An internal government report into the workings of Victoria's Child Safety Commission has revealed a negative culture, bullying and widespread staff dissatisfaction. This report from Dan Oakes.
The report by Victoria's Public Sector Commission was ordered by the previous government following an anonymous complaint. Its findings, obtained by the ABC, reveal an office ridden with factionalism, negativity and physical intimidation. But the Children's Commissioner Bernie Geary doesn't accept the report's conclusions.
My staff report to me that they're feeling happy and certainly their work output is wonderful.
The Minister for Families and Children, Jenny Markakos, wouldn't be drawn on what the report means for the future of Mr. Geary, but described its findings as concerning.
A Supreme Court justice has sentenced a homeless man who raped and murdered a young woman in central Melbourne to 33 years in prison. Scott Miller randomly attacked Yuk Ling Lau as she walked to work along St Kilda Road early one morning last June. Justice Betty King today jailed Miller for a minimum of 28 years. She told Miller Ms Lau would have felt safe walking to work, and her rape and murder was brutal, sadistic and evil.
The circumstances of your offending are such that they cause all of the women in our community to feel less safe and less secure in going about their ordinary daily lives. What you did is probably every woman, as well as every parent's worst nightmare.
A large protest in the centre of Melbourne against the forced closure of Aboriginal communities in Western Australia is wrapping up. Lily Partland is there.
A crowd of about 5,000 gathered at the intersection of Swanston and Flinders Street, but is now dispersing, with many expected to head to King's Domain, where they will continue the protest through the weekend. A small fire burned at the centre of the intersection as speakers talked passionately of the need to shine the spotlight on a range of issues affecting Indigenous Australians. Organisers intended for the rally to shut down Melbourne and declared it a success as traffic and trams came to a halt in the city centre. After the final speaker, the crowd raised their fists in the air and chanted, "We'll be back." Lily Partland, ABC News, Melbourne.
The federal government is signalling it's time to move on and repair Australia's relationship with Indonesia. Anna Henderson has more from Parliament House.
The Foreign Minister, Julie Bishop, was venting her dismay and frustration at the lack of contact from Indonesia ahead of the executions. Last night, the Indonesian ambassador to Australia released a statement expressing sympathy to the friends and family of Andrew Chan and Myuran Sukumaran. Ms. Bishop says it's time to rebuild.
I think it's time for us to seek to move on. We will need to build relations at the government level.
The Deputy Prime Minister, Warren Truss, is also circumspect.
From time to time, there is a hiccup in that relationship. This is one of those moments.
He says the underlying links between the two nations remain strong. Anna Henderson, ABC News, Canberra.
A contractor who was paid hundreds of thousands of dollars by the Victorian Education Department has told the IBAC inquiry into corruption he was just a puppet for his relative Nino Napoli. Guy Stainer reports Napoli was the director of school resources before being sacked.
Daniel Collegia testified he had a printing company that regularly invoiced the department for work not done. The inquiry viewed bank statements showing Mr. Collegia was regularly paid amounts for several thousand dollars by the Department of Education. Most of that money was then transferred into the accounts of either Nino Napoli or his brother Robert Napoli. Mr. Collegia was asked if Nino Napoli always took the lion's share, and he said yes. He testified he was just the puppet of Nino Napoli, who also convinced him to establish another company that was then paid more than $500,000 by the Department of Education.
In sport, tonight's Anzac Rugby League test between Australia and New Zealand has been postponed until Sunday due to torrential rain in Brisbane. The match will kick off at Lang Park at 4 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. The curtain raiser between the Australian women's team and New Zealand's Kiwi Ferns will start at 2 p.m. Victoria's weather, fine apart from the chance of a shower in the far east during the evening. Isolated showers tomorrow developing from the west, mainly in the southwest and over the northern slopes. For Melbourne, cloudy tomorrow, a low of 13, top of 21. Sunday, mostly sunny and 20. Monday, a couple of showers and a forecast top of 21. In Melbourne now, it's 19 degrees. ABC News.